我们可以开始吗？Jai Jai Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jai Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda Jai Jai Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jai Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda Jai Jai Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jai Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda。So this morning we were speaking about Lord Chaitanya's pastimes immediately after taking sannyas.
今天早上我们讲到了主坦塔亚马哈帕布接受萨尼亚喜之后的逍遥时光。
And we heard how Lord Chaitanya went to Shantipur and he met with all the devotees from Mayapur, including his mother.
然后今天早上我们聆听到了主坦塔亚马哈帕布去到了 Shantipur， 并且在 Shantipur 他见到了来自 Mayapur 的所有的奉献者以及他的母亲。
So his mother had a lot of affection for her son, and she requested that he not go too far away.And if he went to Vrindavan, it would be too far away. So she requested that if he could go to Jagannath Puri, it would make a big difference for her. Because then she could get news about his activities.
所以他就请求他的儿子如果能够去扎格纳夫人的话，这样的话呢对他来说就是比较好的，因为他可以经常聆听到有关他的消息。
So it was agreed like that, that Lord Chaitanya accepted the request of his mother, and it was agreed that he would go to stay in Jagannath Puri.
那么主坦塔亚马哈帕布就接受了他母亲的请求，他同意了去扎格纳普里。
So we're going to hear now about how Lord Chaitanya went off to, on his way to Jagannath Puri, and he visited different temples on the way.
今天呢，我们将聆听到主坦塔亚马哈帕布启程去扎格纳普里。在去加加纳普瑞的路上呢，他拜访了很多不同的庙宇。
So he went with four of his devotees. Only four devotees went with them to on the way to Jagannath Puri.
当他去加格纳普瑞的这个过程当中，只有四名奉献者跟随着他。
And every day, Lord Chaitanya liked to do the duty of the sannyasi, and he would go and beg. He would beg some rice and some different things to help to prepare prasadam.
那么呢，茶摊。他每一天都会履行他作为萨尼亚西的职责，都会出去乞讨，一些米呀、和一些谷物用来烹饪和沙的。
So finally, they came to the village of Remuna, which is in the state of Orissa, and it's still some maybe 40-50 kilometers away from Jagannath Puri.
那么呢最终他们来到了一个名叫 Remuna 的一个村庄。这个地方呢大概就是在 Orissa 邦的这个边境的地方，离 Jagannath Puri 大概40英里远左右。
It's a very special holy place, Remuna, then, and there's a beautiful deity of Krishna there, which is called Gopinath.
Ramuna 是一个非常特别的一个朝圣之地，因为在那个地方呢，有一尊非常美丽的 Krishna 的神像，这个神像的名字叫 Gopinath 神像。
And in the temple there, there's also the samadhi of a very great devotee, Rasikananda.
在那里呢，也有一位非常伟大的奉献者的 samadhi， 名字叫 Rasikananda。
Rasikananda was a disciple of Shamananda, who was a student of Jiva Goswami.
Rasikananda 是 Shamananda 的帕布的门徒，而 Shamananda 帕布呢是修了 Jiva Goswami 的门徒。
So the deity of Gopinath is very beautiful, and Lord Chaitanya was happy to visit the temple and offer his obeisances with great devotion.
这个神像呢是非常美丽的，鲁查坦亚看到这个神像的时候，他感到非常的高兴，因此呢他就向这个神像致以顶拜。
When Lord Chaitanya offered his obeisances to the deity, at that time, from the head of the deity, there was a helmet of flowers on the head of Gopinath, and it fell off the deity's head, and it landed on the head of Lord Chaitanya.
因为这个神像，神像的头上呢，他戴着一顶花环。当主财坦亚马哈帕布向神像顶拜的时候呢，这个神像头上的这个顶上的这个花环就落到了马哈帕布的头上。
So when this happened, Lord Chaitanya is very happy, and he chanted and danced in great ecstasy.
所以呢，当这个花环落到马哈帕布头上的时候呢，他感到非常的高兴，因此就唱歌跳舞起来。
All the devotees who were in the temple there, when they saw Lord Chaitanya, they were amazed because he was so attractive, he had so many wonderful qualities, and he had so much love for Krishna.
在场的在庙宇里面的那些奉献者看到这一景象的时候呢，都感到非常的惊奇。他们看到马哈帕布美丽的形体，看到他奇妙的品质，而且他对至尊主超然的爱，这些奉献者们都感到很惊讶，很惊奇。
So, Lord Chaitanya stayed the night there at the temple with the devotees. He was eager to get some of the prasadam.From the deity, because the deity, they offer a special preparation of sweet rice to the deity.
所以呢，那天晚上，彩太马哈帕布和他的这个奉献者们就在这个庙宇里留宿了一夜。而且呢，马哈帕布非常渴望想要得到这个神像的菩萨达，因为供奉给这个神像的菩萨达是非常特别的，一种甜奶饭。
And Lord Chaitanya had heard about the pastimes of this deity from his spiritual master.
而且之前呢，主财坦亚马哈帕布从他的灵性导师那里聆听到了有关这个神像的逍遥时光。
Does anybody know the name of Lord Chaitanya's spiritual master?
有人知道主财坦亚马哈帕布的灵性导师的名字吗？
Is Charuchitra there? Does she know?
Maybe. I remember is Ishwari.
Ishwara Puri.
Ishwara Puri,
yeah, very good. Yeah.So Ishwara Puri was the spiritual master of Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya, where did he get his initiation? Do you remember?
Ishwara Puri 是主财坦亚马哈帕布的灵性导师。那么他是在哪里得到启迪的吗？启迪的呢？谁记得？
Somebody else know?
其他人知道吗？
Nobody knows.
Tarumati.
Gaya.
Gaya, right. Yeah, Gaya. Yeah. Lord Chaitanya had gone to Gaya. Why did Lord Chaitanya go to Gaya?
Lord Chaitanya 去了 Gaya. 那他为什么会去 Gaya 呢？
One reason was to get initiation from Ishwara Puri.
其中一个原因是，他要得到 Ishwara Puri 的启迪。
But he didn't say that. Initially, he had another reason why he said, "I'm going to Gaya." He had an excuse.
但是，最初的时候他并没有这么做。最初的时候，他是以另一种理由，为由去 Gaya 的。
父亲离开躯体了。
父亲 ，Yeah, he went to do the Shraddha ceremony on behalf of his father.
他去那里是为了为他的父亲举行这个 Shraddha 的祭祀仪式。
Yeah, after the father or somebody in the family goes, and you can go to Gaya, and there's the footprint of Lord Vishnu there in Gaya, and you do a special ritual there.
就是当我们的家中的长辈或者有亲人离世之后，我们可以去 Gaya， 在 Gaya 呢有一个有一尊 Vishnu 的足印，我们可以在那里举行特别的祭祀仪式。
And it's very good for the next life of the departed soul.
这对于那个已经离世的灵魂的下一世是非常有好处的。
So Ishwara Puri told Lord Chaitanya about this deity, about this Gopinath deity.
So Ishwara Puri 呢就把关于这个神像的逍遥时光告诉给了古塔坦亚马哈帕布。
This deity had become very famous because it had stolen a pot of sweet rice.
这个神像呢，它非常的有名，因为呢，它曾经偷了一罐甜奶饭。
So it got the name Shira Chora Gopinath. Shira is the sweet rice, and Chora means the thief, and Gopinath, name of Krishna.
所以这尊神像的名字呢，就被称为 Shira Chora Gopinath. 这个 Shira 的意思是甜奶饭。Chora 的意思就是小偷，而 Gopinath 呢是指 Krishna。
So Krishna is famous as a great thief.
The Krishna 以一个伟大的小偷而闻名。
Right. What else did he steal? Somebody can tell me. Somebody else besides Subhuti, besides Subhuti and Charuchitra, somebody else knows what did Krishna steal?
Krishna 还偷窃过什么其他的东西？大家有人知道吗
？Krishna 还偷了奶油，
还偷奶油，
还偷了牛奶。
Okay, very good. 还有什么？
还偷了肚皮姑娘的衣服。
Yes, very good. Yes, right. Thank you. Stole the clothes of the gopis. Yes. Okay.Yeah, he steals the hearts of his devotees. So, this deity, Gopinath deity, he stole the pot of sweet rice for his devotee.
那么这个神像呢，这个叫做 Chira Chora Gopinath 的这个神像呢，为他的一名奉献者偷了一罐甜奶饭。
Yeah, a great devotee had come there. A great devotee, his name was Madhavendra Puri.
一名伟大的奉献者去了那里。这名伟大的奉献者的名字叫 Madhavendra Puri.
Madhavendra Puri was he was the guru of Ishwarapuri.
Manavendrapuri is Ishwarapuri 的宁静导师。
And he also became the guru of Advaita Acharya.
而且他也是 Advaita Acharya 的宁静导师。
So one time Madhavendrapuri had gone to Vrindavan and he was at the side of the Govardhan Hill.
有一次呢 Madhavendrapuri 来到了 Vrindavan 的这个哥瓦丹山。
So he was so happy to be at Govardhan that he did not know when it was day or when it was night.He did not know, sometimes he stood up, sometimes he fell down.
他非常高兴来能够来到这个哥瓦丹山，他非常的处在这个极乐当中，他甚至不知道是白天还是黑夜，他有的时候站起来，有的时候倒在地上。
So he circumambulated the Govardhan Hill, and then he came to the Govinda Kund, one of the...Kund's there on the side of Govardhan Hill called Govinda Kund, and he took his bath there.
然后呢，他就绕拜了哥瓦丹山。绕拜之后呢，他就来到了哥瓦丹昆，Govinda Kund。这个 Govinda Kund 呢，是哥瓦丹山旁边的一个湖，因此呢，他就在这个 Govinda Kund 的沐浴，然后呢，就在树底下坐了下来。
So then He found a nice tree to sit under the tree, and while he was sitting under the tree, then a young cowherd boy came and brought him a pot of milk.
于是呢，他就在这个树底下坐了下来。当他坐在这个树底下的时候，来了一个美丽的男孩，有一个美丽的男孩来到他面前。
So Madhavendrapuri, he.Would never beg for anything. If people gave him food, then he would eat, but he would never ask people to give him food.
Manavendrapuri 呢，他从来不会去乞讨食物，就是如果人们有人给他吃的东西，他就会吃；如果没人给他的话，他就不定吃。
So the cowherd boy brought the milk for Madhavendrapuri, and he told Madhavendrapuri.Please drink the milk. I brought it for you.
所以呢，这个男孩呢，这个木流红男孩呢，就给 Madhavendrapuri 带来了一罐牛奶。他就对 Madhavendrapuri 说，请喝下这个牛奶。
Then he asked Madhavendrapuri, he said, "Why don't you go and beg some food to eat? Why are you fasting?"
然后他就问 Madhavendrapuri, 你为什么？不去乞讨一些食物呢？你为什么不吃东西呢
？So when Madhavendrapuri saw the cowherd boy, he was very happy and he forgot all about hunger and thirst.
所以当 Madhavendrapuri 看到这个美丽的男孩的时候，他感到非常的高兴，甚至忘记了饥饿和口渴。
And Madhavendrapuri asked the boy, "Who are you?" Where do you live? How do you know I was fasting?
Madhavendrapuri 就问这个男孩，你是谁呢？你住在哪里？你是怎么知道我在戒食的呢？
And the little boy said, "Oh, I'm just a cowherd boy. I live in this village. In my village, nobody fasts."
这个男孩就回答说，我是一个木牛棚，而且呢，我住在这个村子里。在我的村庄里没有人戒食。
He said, "In this village, they said anybody can beg food from others, and then they can eat."
他说呢，在这个村子里呢，每个人都可以去从其他人那里乞讨一些食物，然后去吃东西。
Some people drink only milk.
有的人只喝牛奶。
And if somebody doesn't ask anyone for food, then I will come and I will give him food.
但是如果一个人不向其他人索要食物的话，我就会亲自提供给他吃的东西。
Some of the village ladies, they saw you. They came here to take water from the Govinda Kund, and they saw you, and they give me the milk to come and give it to you.
有一些村子里的 妇女来这里打水的时候看见了你，所以呢他就把这个牛奶给我，让我把这个牛奶给你送过来。
I have to give you the milk. I'll give you this milk and I have to go because I have to go and take care of the cows. It's time to milk the cows.
现在呢我就把这个牛奶给你，但是现在呢我要去照顾奶牛了，因为现在是挤奶的时候，我要去照顾奶牛了。
But I'll come back. I need to get that milk pot back from you.
这个男孩继续说呢，但是我会回来的，我会把这个罐子拿回去。
So then the boy immediately just disappeared. Madhavendra Puri didn't know where he went.
然后呢这个男孩就突然就消失不见了。Madhavendra Puri 呢感到很惊讶。
Madhavendra Puri still got the pot and he kept it, but the boy never came back to get the pot.
这个罐子呢，这个牛奶罐还是在 Madhavendra Puri 的这里。但是呢这个男孩再也没有回来取这个罐子。
So that night, Madhavendra Puri was chanting the Maha Mantra. He was chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. He could not sleep.
所以那天晚上呢 Madhavendra Puri 就一直在唱诵 Maha Mantra, 然后他也不能入睡。
So it came to the end of the night, he was tired and he fell asleep. And in the dream, he saw that same boy who had come and given him the milk.
然后呢，因为他一整夜都没有睡觉，因此呢，在这个夜色将近的时候，他有一些困乏了，所以他就慢慢就睡着了。然后他睡着之后，他就做了一个梦。在梦里面他见到了之前的那个美丽的男孩。
The same boy who had brought him the milk, he saw that same boy.
就是他看到的是那个给他送牛奶的那个同一个男孩。
And the boy came and he took the hand of Madhavendra Puri. In the dream he took his hand and he brought him to a bush in the jungle and he told him that,There's a deity of Krishna here.
那么在梦中呢，这个男孩就拉着 Madhavendra Puri 的手，就牵着他，把他带到了一个灌木丛，就对他说呢，我住在这个灌木丛里。
Yeah, the boy told Madhavendra Puri, he said, I'm living here in this bush.And I suffer from the cold and the rain and the wind and the heat.
这个男孩呢就对 Madhavendra Puri 说，我住在这个灌木丛里，而且因为这个呢，我遭受了许多的严寒、大雨、狂风和酷暑的痛苦。
So the cowherd boy told Madhavendra Puri, please, you get the people of the village to help you and get me out from here, and then.Help, you can make a temple for me on top of the hill.
然后呢，这个男孩就对 Madhavendra Puri 说到呢，请把村子里的人带来，让他们把我从这个灌木丛当中带出来，然后呢，为我建造一座庙宇在山顶上。
And then the boy said to Madhavendra Puri, I want you to install, to put me in the temple and.Bring a lot of cold water and get my body nice and clean.
然后这个男孩呢就继续对 Madhavendra Puri 说道，你呢要把我设立在那个庙宇里，然后呢用大量的冷水清洁我的身体。
The boy said, I've been waiting for you to come for a long time. I was wondering when you would come to save me.
这个男孩说道呢，我已经等待你很长时间了，我一直在想你什么时候会来服务我呢。
He said, when my deity appears, then it will give a lot of mercy to people. They'll be they'll be purified just by seeing me and my transcendental form.
嗯，这个因为这个神像的显现呢，会给人们带来仁慈，仅仅是因为觐见到这个神像，人们呢就会得到很多的净化。
He said, "My name is Gopal, and I'm the whole. I lift up Govardhan Hill."
他说到呢，我的名字叫 Gopal, 我是举起哥瓦丹山的人。
He said, "I was put here by the grandson of Krishna. Krishna's grandson is called Bajra, and he put me here."
他说到呢，我是由这个Krishna 的孙子。把我设立在这里的，这 Krishna 的孙子名字叫 Bajra。
But then after some time, the Muslims attacked, and the priest who was taking care of me, he had to hide me in the bush in the jungle.
但是呢，过了一段时间之后，就有穆斯林来进攻了。当穆斯林进攻的时候呢，服务我的祭司就把我藏在了这个灌木丛里。
So the priest left me here in the jungle. I've been waiting for somebody to take me out. So you're the right person. You can take me. You can take care of me.
所以呢，这个祭司呢就把我藏在了这个灌木丛里。我就一直在等待着有个人能够把我从这个灌木丛当中带出来。所以呢，你是这个合适的人选。
So when the boy spoke to Madhavendra Puri like that, then Madhavendra Puri didn't know what to do. He cried.
当这个男孩呢像 Madhavendra Puri 这样说话的时候呢，Madhavendra Puri 他不知如何是好，他就哭了起来。
Anyway.Madhavendra Puri got all the people from the village, and they all went to the Govardhan Hill to look in the bushes, and then they were able to find the deity.
然后呢，这个 Madhavendra Puri 就召集了村庄里的这些村民，然后呢，就一起来到了这个哥瓦丹山的这个灌木丛当中，去寻找这个神像。
There was a lot of trees, a lot of jungle. They had to go through everything to find the deity.
在这个山里面呢，有很多的灌木丛，有很多的树木，所以呢，他们就一直这样的去寻找神像。
They cut the bushes. They made a path into the jungle.
然后呢，他们就在这个丛林里面就开辟了一条道路。
So then Madhavendra Puri brought the people to the hill, and he took away the different bushes, and they saw the deity there in the ground.Covered with dirt and grass was growing over it. All the people from the village, they were very shocked.
所以呢，这个 Madhavendra Puri 就带着村民们，就是来到这个哥瓦丹山，然后呢，就穿过这个浓密的灌木丛去寻找到了这个神像。他们看到这个神像身上带着很多的泥呀和草。然后村民们看到的时候都感到非常的惊讶。
So the deity was quite heavy, and one man could not lift. They needed several men. They had to be strong men to be able to carry the deity.
这个神像非常的沉重，一个人是搬不动它的，所以呢，要有好几个强壮的人来一起搬动它。
So they put the deity on a big stone.And then they had a big stone at the back also to hold up the deity.
然后呢，他们就把这个神像放在了一个大石头上，这个大石头就相当于是他的宝座座位。然后呢，在他的后背也放了一
块石头来支撑他。
Then they brought all the water. They got water from the lake Govindakund. Were there? They brought the water there, and they used that water to bathe the deity.
然后呢，他们就从这个 Govindakund 去取了很多的水，他们就用这个水为神像沐浴。
And they, when they were bathing the deity, they were also, there was a lot of music, they were playing drums and blowing bugles, and women were singing songs.
在为神像沐浴的时候呢，也响起了这个唱歌的声音，有还有喇叭的声音、敲鼓的声音和女子们唱诵的声音。
Some people sang, some people danced, everyone was very happy.
有的人在唱歌，有的人在跳舞，每一个人都非常的快乐。
Because this is a festival, the Lord has appeared, so everybody is very happy, and so everybody wants to celebrate the festival. They want to get the blessings of the deity.
因为呢，这是一个节日，因为呢，神像显现了，所以这是一个节日，大家呢都很高兴，想要来参加这个节日。
And all the people in the village, in the villages nearby, they all have cows, they have many cows, so they all had a lot of milk and yogurt and butter, and they would bring it for the festival. And the people from the villages brought tulsi leaves and flowers, different kinds of cloth.
所以村民们呢带来了这些奶制品，同时也带来了很多的杜拉西叶、鲜花和各种衣服。
So the idea is to get rid of everything which is inauspicious. We get rid of it by chanting the mantras, and then they create auspiciousness by doing the bathing of the deity.
通过为神像沐浴，就是通过用这些吉祥的物品为神，供奉给神像，然后唱诵，这样为神像沐浴就可以制造出吉祥的氛围。
Then from the deity.But what with the deity, they massage the deity with oil. They bring some bottle of oil, like sandalwood oil, and they will use that to massage the body of the deity, makes the body of the deity shine.
在为神像沐浴的时候呢，通常也会用一些油来按摩神像的身体，比如说这个檀香香，还有其他的一些香油来给这个神像，按摩身体。
So they used all the things for the Abhishek, they use the Panchagavya and Panchamrit, both very important.
所以这个叫做为神像沐浴的仪式。叫 Panchagavya.
Yeah, Panchagavya. There's Panchamrit and Panchagavya.
就是我们为神像沐浴的时候，会用到这个 Panchagavya 和 Panchamrita。
Panchamrit means all the things, very sweet things. For example, the milk and yogurt and ghee and also honey and sugar.
这个 Panchamrita 通常指的就是那些甜的，比如说牛奶、酸奶、酥油、蜂蜜和糖，这些甜的东西叫做 Panchamrita。
And Panchagavya are things which come from the cow, and you've got the milk and the yogurt in the ghee, and then you've got cow urine and cow dung.
Panchagavya 指的是来自母牛的。五种这个制品，比如牛奶、酸奶、酥油、牛粪和牛尿。
So Krishna would be bathed in these different things.
所以呢，就是会用这些不同的物品来为 Krishna 的这个神像沐浴。
And this way Krishna, and this way the devotee is living there is very happy. He feels the presence of Krishna in his house.
对，让你的村民呢都感到非常的高兴，因为他们看到了 Krishna 的临在，他们来到了 Krishna 的家。
And while they do the bathing, they also chant the Maha Mantra and different prayers, glorifying the Lord.
在他们为神像沐浴的时候呢，他们也会唱诵 Maha Mantra， 还有一些荣耀主的歌曲。
该存电话当儿子，该存电话相关的人物那个电话号得存上，别到时候这个连不上，那个连不上，拿电话去。156-6302-8809.
Are we okay?
Okay.
So then they give the deity also a massage with oil and make the body of the deity shine.
然后呢，他们就用这个油给神像的身体，这个按摩，然后使得这个神像变得非常的有光泽。
So this way the deity was made very clean, and then they got nice clothes for the deity. They dressed the deity with new cloth, and they put sandalwood pulp and tulsi garlands and flowers around the deity.
然后呢？经过沐浴之后呢，神像就变得非常的洁净，然后呢，人们呢也给他换上了漂亮的衣服，给他涂抹上了这个檀香浆，为他戴上布拉什的花环和鲜花的花环。
And then incense and light some ghee lamps also and offer to the deity, and then different food offered to the deity, yogurt and milk and different sweets.
然后呢，就为神像，供奉了香和灯，然后也为神像供奉了各种各样的食物，包括酸奶、牛奶和各种各样的甜品。
So the deity was given many different foods and different drinking water.
所以首先呢，神像呢就被供奉了许多的食物、水。还有这个各种各样的食物和水。
And then finally, they offered prayers and obeisances and prayed to the deity for surrender, to fully surrender.
然后呢，人们就供奉了各种的祷文，并且向神像致以顶拜，就是在神像面前致以五体投地的顶拜。
So when the people in the village understood that the deity was going to be installed, then they were very happy.
村民们知道这个神像即将被设立，他们都感到非常的高兴。
So that's why they brought many quantities of different foodstuffs and grains.
所以呢，他们就带来了很多的食物，比如说米呀、麦粉等等。
Dal, wheat, all these things which they use every day.
所以他们带来了他们每天会使用的这些食材，比如说大米啊，还有这种稻，就是一种豆子，还有小麦粉。
So then they had a big stack of rice, dal and flour.So the next morning they began the cooking. They had big cooking. They got big cooking pots and they cooked a big feast.
然后他们带来了这些食材呢，在第二天的时候，他们就用各种各样烹饪用的罐子，就是烹饪这些食材，做了丰盛的大餐。
And they had 10 Brahmins cooking.
有十个 Brahmana 在做饭。
And they had five Brahmanas cooking the vegetables, and 10 Brahmanas cooking the grain.
这十个 Brahmana 呢，他们是专门做这个谷 物的、粮食的，而另外五个 Brahmana 呢，专门做蔬菜类的食物。
Then there were people making chapatis, because people in Vrindavan, they're more accustomed to eat chapati than rice.
然后呢，有很多的人在做 chapati， 因为在 Vrindavan 的人们呢，习惯于吃这个 chapati。
Yeah. When you're in Bengal and Mayapur, everybody eats rice. They eat a lot of rice.
在孟加拉，在马尔普这个地方呢，人们习惯于吃米饭。
But in Vrindavan, it's a place where they grow. The climate is very dry, very different from Mayapur. So it's very dry. So they grow wheat, and everybody will eat chapati.
而在Vrindavan 呢，这个Vrindavan 它的气候比较干燥。和麦尔普是完全不一样的，所以在文达文那个地方呢，人们都种植的是麦子，所以他们吃的通常是 chapati。
And they put ghee on top of the chapati, makes it very tasty.
他们会在这个 chapati 上面涂抹这个酥油，这样的话会使得 chapati 非常的美味可口。
And then they cooked a lot of rice because people also still need to eat rice. Even though they eat chapati, they still like to eat rice.
而且呢，他们也烹饪了很多的米饭，即便是已经有 chapati 了，但是人们还是要吃米饭的，所以他们也做了很多的米饭。
So there are pots of yogurt, milk, and buttermilk.
所以他们做了很多的这个酸奶、牛奶。
And there were people with many pots of cream and buttermilk and yogurt put on the vegetables.
所以人们就做了一罐又一罐的这个牛奶呀、酸奶呀，这还有很多的蔬菜制品。
So this festival was called Anakut. Anna means grain, and kut giving the offering to Krishna. Anakut. So every year Govardhan Puja, we do this Anakut. We give the grains to offer everything to Krishna.Your voice is too soft. You have to put your volume up. Haribol? No, it's too soft. You have to come louder.Speak something. Let me hear you.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Okay, a bit better.
Okay.
So Madhavendra Puri, he came to do the offering, to make the offering to Gopal.
对 Madhavendra Puri 呢，他就安排了这个对 Gopal 神像的供奉。
Because the deity's name is Gopal, he's very hungry, he's not eaten for a long time. So everything was be offered.
这个神像的名字叫 Gopal, 这个 Gopal 因为他已经饿了很多天了。
So they had also water pots with nice fragrant water, scented water for drinking.
所以呢，这个 这个村民们就为神像供奉了很多的食物，还有用来喝的这个有香味的水。
So everything was offered to the deity, and the deity ate everything. Gopal ate everything, but everything remained just like it was before.
所以所有的这些供奉呢，都供奉给了神像 Gopa。Gopa 呢，就吃掉了所有的这些供奉，但是呢，他还是把这些供奉，留成他原本的样子，让这些供奉，还是原本的样子。
Krishna eats everything offered by his devotees.
Krishna 会接受奉献者为他供奉的所有的一切。
But the food is, it looks just the same, but the quality is different.
看起来这个食物，这些供奉没有什么变化，但是实际上这些供奉的物品的本质已经改变了。
Right. Before the food is offered, it's different. After it's offered, then it's transcendental.
在这个食物没有被供奉之前呢，它是不一样的。而一旦被供奉之后呢，它就变成超然的。
Whatever food is offered to Krishna is as good as Krishna.
无论我们给 Krishna 供奉什么样的物品，这个供奉之后的这些物品就变得和 Krishna 一样的好。
Krishna can eat the food by seeing the food or by touching it.
Krishna 只要去通过瞥视或者触碰这个食物，就可以接受这个食物了。
Krishna does not have to eat it. He does not become hungry like us.
Krishna 呢，并不需要就是亲自去吃掉它。Krishna 不会像我们一样会饥饿。
Krishna can eat anything, doesn't matter what the quantity. He can eat so much.
Krishna 他可以吃很多东西，这个无论有多少的量都不要紧，他都可以吃掉，都可以接受。
But if we want to understand Krishna's eating,we have to purify our consciousness by devotional service.
如果我们要想明白 Krishna 是如何进食的话，我们要用通过这个奉献服务来净化我们的感官，
we cannot,
来去理解这一点。
We cannot understand Krishna just by our limited mind and senses.
我们不可能通过我们这个受局限的感官和心意。
But Madhavendra Puri, he could understand that everything was being offered to Krishna and Krishna was accepting, Krishna was eating. Madhavendra Puri had that spiritual vision, he could seeKrishna accepting the offering.
因为 Madhavendra Puri 他拥有明镜的视域，他能够看到 Krishna 如何接受了这些供奉的物品。
So this whole festival about Gopal, this was all done in one day. It was all arranged in one day. Nobody, it's inconceivable how the whole thing happened just in one day. It was all arranged and all done in one day.
所以这个关于 Gopa 的这个节目呢，是在一天之内就完成了，所以这是非常不可思议的。这么一个盛大的这个节日，在一天之内就完成了。
But Prabhupada said, just like Krishna consciousness, we have spread Krishna consciousness all over the world in a short time.
正如说到 Prabhupada 所说到的，我们短的时间内就把 Krishna 知觉传遍了整个世界。
And if we're strict devotees, then Krishna will empower us to distribute Krishna consciousness more and more.
因为这个我们得到了这个授权，能够去把这个 Krishna 知觉越来越多的派发给更多的人。
We just have to preach Lord Chaitanya's message. and spread the teachings.
我们只需要去传播主财坦亚马哈华布的这个教导，去传扬他的讯息。
It all happens by the grace of Krishna, not the devotee, but by the grace of Krishna.
所有的这一切都是凭借着 Krishna 的仁慈而发生的，不是奉献者，是由于 Krishna 的仁慈。
So Madhavendra Puri offered nice water to Gopal to wash his mouth.
所以呢，这个 Madhavendra Puri 就给 Gopal 供奉了这个用来漱口的水。
And then everybody was chanting Jai Gopal, Jai Gopal. They're so happy to see the deity come.
然后在那里喊着 Jai Gopal, Jai Gopal. 他们看到这尊神像的到来，都感到非常的高兴。
So then they put the deity to rest. Madhavendra Puri got some cot for the deity that could be like his bed.
接着呢，他们就安排主休息。Madhavendra Puri 就拿来了一个新的床垫，把这个床垫铺好。
And then they made a temporary temple.
然后呢，他就在这个床的周围呢盖上了草席，这样的话，一个临时的庙宇就准备好了。
And they made a bed for the deity with a straw mattress over it.
他就为神像准备了一个床，然后这个床的周围呢还盖着这个草席、草垫子。
And after they put the deity to rest, then Madhavendra Puri told all the brahmanas, said, "Now distribute prasadam to everyone."
他们让这个神像休息之后呢 ，Madhavendra Puri 就召集来了那些 brahmana， 然后对他们说，把这些食物派发给所有的人。
They wanted to give prasadam to everyone, from the dogs, the children, the old men, the women, everybody get prasadam.
他们希望每一个人都能够得到 prasadam， 无论是狗，还是小孩，还是老人，还是妇女。
So first they gave all the brahmanas along with their wives, they fed them.
首先呢，是这个食物呢是被给予了 Brahmana 以及他们的妻子。
Because the Brahmanas, they are considered, they give them respect. They think, oh, they're higher class, higher caste. So give them honor. Let them take prasadam first.
因为呢，这个 Brahmana 被认为是最高阶层的人，所以呢，为了向他们表达敬意，因此会先把食物派发给他们。
So they gave the prasadam to all the people, not just only the people of Govardhan. They gave it to all the people from other villages, everybody. They all got prasadam. There was enough for everybody.
所以呢，他们就把这个食物派发给了所有的人，不仅仅是哥瓦丹山的这个人，还有很多来自于其他村庄的人。他们把这些食物就派发给了所有的人。
All the villages nearby heard that the deity had been found, a new deity had appeared in Govardhan, so they all came, they all wanted to see the deity.
还有那些附近村庄的人们听说这个神像显现了，所以他们都感到非常的高兴，前来觐见这个神像。
So this was all the mercy of Madhavendra Puri.
这都是由于 Madhavendra Puri 的仁慈。Yeah.
The festival was just like when Lord Krishna was there 5,000 years ago, when they had the Anakut, when Krishna picked up the Govardhan Hill.
他们举行的这个节目吗？节目叫做 Anakuta。这个 Anakuta 的节目呢是，实际上是五千年前当 Krishna 举起哥瓦丹山的时候。人们所庆祝的这个节日。
So Madhavendra Puri was having the similar festival. This was before the time of Lord Chaitanya, remember?
所以呢 ，Madhavendra Puri 就举行了这个类似的这个 安娜库塔的这个庆祝仪式，而这个时间甚至是早于主财太马哈卡布。
And then Madhavendra Puri initiated the Brahmanas into Vaishnavas. He made them Vaishnavas because not all Brahmanas are Vaishnavas. So Madhavendra Puri initiated them and made them Vaishnavas.
然后呢 ，Madhavendra Puri 就启迪了那些在场的 Brahmana， 因为Brahmana 不一定是 Vaishnava。所以呢，这个 Madhavendra Puri 就把这些婆罗门、这些 Brahmana 就启迪进入了 Vaishnava 中。
Yeah, somebody is going to worship the deity, it must be a Vaishnava.
因为如果一个人要崇拜神像的话，他必须是一名 Vaishnava。
And a Vaishnava is on a higher position than a Brahmana.
Vaishnava 的地位要比 Brahmana 要崇高。
So these people were Brahmanas, that was their caste. They were by birth Brahmanas, but they had become initiated into the line of this Madhavendra Puri.
这些 Brahmana 们，他们是世袭的 Brahmana， 也就是他们出生于这些婆罗门的家庭。然后呢，这些 Brahmana 就得到了 Madhavendra Puri 的启迪。
So initiation is important, even if you're a Brahmana.
So, 启迪是非常重要的，即便你是一个 Brahmana.
So, Madhavendra Puri wanted to see the deity worship properly.
Madhavendra Puri 希望看到这个神像得到很好的崇拜。
And so when everybody heard about the new deity, how a deity had appeared, so people from faraway places, they all came. And they all came and they all brought things. Somebody brought rice, somebody brought wheat, somebody brought some vegetables and fruit.
所以呢，这个其他地方的这些人们听说这个神像显现了，他们就很高兴。他们就从很远的地方前来见这个神像，并且带来了很多的谷物、麦子、蔬菜和水果等等。
So this festival, they had every day, day after day it was going on, not just one day. They did it the next day, and then the next day, different villages would all come, they'd bring food. So they'd do it again.
所以呢，就这样，他们就每天的去举行这个节目，不是只有一天在进行这个节目，他们是一天又一天的，因为呢，有很多来自不同村庄的这些村民带来很多的这些食物啊、贡品。所以呢，他们就是每天都举行的这样盛大的节目。
And Madhavendra Puri didn't eat anything during the day. He was just busy with service to the deity. He didn't eat anything.
Madhavendra Puri 在白天的时候一整天都没有吃东西，因为他忙着在服务神像，所以他一整天白天没有吃东西。
But at night, he would, after they put the deity to rest, then he would take some milk.
但是在晚上呢，等神像休息之后呢，他会喝一点牛奶。
Yeah. And then the next morning, then they wake the deity up, and people would come, and they'd come with different preparations to offer to the deity.
然后呢，第二天清晨的时候呢，他们又会把神像唤醒，然后呢，人们。又会向神像供奉各种各样的物品。
Yeah, they bring whatever grains they had in their village, maybe rice or wheat, and they would bring some fruit, vegetable.
那些村庄里的这些居民们呢，就给神像带来了他们村里的尽可能多的这个粮食、酥油、酸奶和牛奶。
So this is Krishna consciousness, that there's no scarcity. Krishna provides and the devotees distribute for everyone. They don't hoard anything, they don't keep it for themselves. Whatever they get, they distribute.
所以呢，这就是 Krishna 知觉，没有任何的匮乏。Krishna 会提供一切，然后奉献者们又会派发出去。奉献者们不会把这些贡品呢私自藏起来，而是会广为派发。
Maybe we have to show, we have to understand this with more faith. How Krishna provides for everyone.How Krishna is taking care of everyone, providing everything.
所以呢，要理解这一点，我们需要一些信心，来明白 Krishna 他是如何在维系着每一个人，他是如何在照顾着每一个人。
So when the village people came, they got very nice prasadam given to them. So they were very happy.
所以当这些村民到来的时候呢，他们得到了非常好的 prasada， 他们都非常的高兴。
And some people would bring cows to offer to the temple.
有的人带来了母牛，来，就是布施给庙宇。
And then some people, somebody like was doing some construction business.So he built a wall around the temple.
还有的人呢，就是为这个庙宇修建了这个围墙。
And somebody else, people would bring different ornaments to donate to the deity. So they would leave some different necklace or pearl necklace or chain or something for the deity.
而有的人呢，就为神像带来了各种的饰品。这样的话，神像就有了很多的项链啊，珍珠项链啊，还有各种各样的首饰等等。
So in this way, the deity was having, it had more and more property, the assets of the deity, the property and the grains and the wealth of the deity became more and more.
所以呢，这个神像呢就变得越来越富裕了，有很多的谷物。金银首饰，很多的这些贡品。
They said in every family in Vrindavan, they would contribute one cow for the deity. So this way, Gopal got many, many cows.
这个 Vrindavan 的每一户居民呢，都为这个神像布置了一头乳牛，所以呢，这个 Gopal 就拥有了成千上万头的乳牛。
And then two brahmanas came, and Madhavendra Puri liked them very much, and he kept them there, and he put them in charge for taking care of the deity.
然后呢，这个时候又来了两名 sannyasi， 然后 Madhavendra Puri 非常喜欢他们，就要他们专门负责服务这个神像。
So in this way, the worship of the deity became very nice, very attractive.
就这样呢，对这个神像的崇拜就变得非常的华丽，安排的非常的周到，
deity,
非常的好。
The deity worship is very important in every temple. You have to take care of the deities very nicely.
这个神像崇拜呢，在每一个庙宇里都是非常重要的，因此呢，要非常好的去崇拜和照顾这个神像。
So this worship was going on for 2 years. And then after 2 years, Madhavendra Puri had another dream.
那么这样的崇拜呢就一直持续了两年的时间。两年之后呢 Madhavendra Puri 又做了一个梦。
And in his dream, Gopal, the deity, came to him and said that I'm very hot.You have to get me some sandalwood to put on my body, to cool my body. It's too hot.
然后在这个梦里呢，这个 Gopal 的神像又对这个 Madhavendra Puri 说到呢，我的身体太热了，你要找一些檀香浆来涂抹我的身体，因为我的身体太热了。
I want you to bring sandalwood from Jagannath Puri. Go quickly. Only you can do this. You have to go.
你要赶快去加格纳普里为我收一些檀香浆。你快点去。只有你能够做这个事情。
So Madhavendra Puri was very happy to get this order from the deity. But before he goes,
他得到了。
He has to make arrangements to make sure the deity worship will be done nicely while he's away.
但是呢，他要确保他在离开的期间，这个神像仍然能够得到很好的崇拜和照顾。
So Madhavendra Puri left Govardhan and he goes to Jagannath Puri, and on the way there.He went through Shantipur, and that was when he met Advaita Acharya.
So, Madhavendra Puri 就离开了欧瓦丹山，去了加格纳普瑞。在去普瑞的途中呢，他来到了Shantipur, Advaita Acharya 的家。
Advaita Acharya understands this Madhavendra Puri is really a great devotee, and he gets initiation from him. He accepts Madhavendra Puri as his guru.
Advaita Acharya 呢，他知道 Madhavendra Puri 是一名非常伟大的奉献者，因此呢，他想要从他那里接受启迪。所以呢，这个 Advaita Acharya 就请求这个 Madhavendra Puri 成为他的灵性导师。
And after Shantipur, then Madhavendra Puri went to Rimuna. He came to this Rimuna where the Gopinath deity is.
在经过这个山提普尔之后呢，马德文达普里就来到了这个名为瑞穆纳的村庄。在这个瑞穆纳村庄里，就有这一尊名为 Gopinatha 的神像。
So Madhavendra Puri wants to know about. He's interested to know what kind of things are they offering to the deity. What kind of preparations are they making for the deity here?
所以，当马德温加夫人来到这个里的时候呢，他就想知道，在这里的这个 Gopinath 的神像，他得到了是什么样的供奉？
He、
所以，他很想知道这个供奉的是什么。
He could see it was a very nice temple, very nice arrangements. So he understood they must also be doing nice offerings for the deity.
因为呢，他看到在这个村庄的这个庙宇里面。这个庙宇非常的华美，所有的这个崇拜都做得非常的好，因此呢，他就知道这个供奉的食物也一定是一流的。
So he asked the brahmana there, the brahmana who's doing the puja, what kind of foods do you offer to the deity? And the brahmana told him about all the different preparations he offered.
所以呢，他就问这个。Brahmana, 这个 Brahmana 呢正在为神像举行这个 Puja 的仪式。Madhavendra Puri 呢就问这个 Brahmana, 这个 Brahmana 呢就向他解释了为神像供奉的所有的这些食物和供品。
And the Brahmana told him, every evening we offer sweet rice in 12 pots, 12 clay pots is offered to the deity.
这个Brahmana 呢就告诉 Madhavendra Puri, 他们每天晚上都会为神像供奉12罐的甜奶饭。
And the Brahmana told them, the taste of this sweet rice is just like nectar.
这个 Brahmana 就对这个 Madhavendra Puri 说呢，这个甜奶饭的味道就好像甘露一般。
Yeah, very special, famous all over the world.This is the Gopinath Shira.
这个名为 Gopinath Shira 的这种甜奶饭呢，非常的有名，闻名全世界。
And he said it's not offered anywhere else in the world.
因为呢，在世界上的任何其他地方，
So when Madhavendra Puri hears about this sweet rice, he's very interested to find out how it's made and to get some that he can make it for his deity at Govardhan.
So, 因为呢，他也想为他的这个欧巴。